Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 12 of our GoLang course. In this lesson, we are going to explore the bitwise logical operators that we learned in the previous lesson, true code. Before starting, I would like to introduce you to a smart shortcut which is available in VS Code. So if you type pkgm then press enter, it will autofill your main.go file with package main and the main function. Before starting, let me just write out what we are going to cover in this section. So in this lesson, we are going to cover OR AND, XOR AND NOT and the invert operator. We are also going to look at printing ints in binary form. Before performing any operation, let us create three variables. The first is var a unsigned int 8, and I will assign a value that we used in our lesson, that is 202. Then I will have var b unsigned int 8141. I'm using unsigned int because if you remember from our integers lesson, a signed int has one bit or the first bit to denote the sign of the value stored. So it tells you if the value stored is negative or positive. And it is highly recommended that for binary operations or where you are performing binary mathematics to use unsigned integers, because using signed integers can lead to unexpected results. First, we are going to look at the OR operator. So I'm going to assign the value from the OR operator to a new variable called C. So C colon equals A bar sign B. This reads at C colon equal A or B. Now if we print the value with fmt print lin C, we should see 207 printed to the console. As you can see, 207 was indeed printed to the console. This is the same as we calculated in the previous lesson. Now it would help if we could print these values in their binary forms or in binary numbers. So we can use the strconv package to do that. Strconv is a package that has a bunch of functions that you can use to convert different types to strings and vice versa. So I'm going to use strconv or strconv.format unsigned int. The first value it takes is of type unsigned int 64. So I'm just going to typecast our value into unsigned int 64, and the next value it takes is of the base of the number. So if you remember, binary numbers use the base 2. Next, I will copy and output the value of b and c respectively in their binary forms. Now we can run our program and say go run main.go. As you can see, we have 207 printed and the binary representation of A and B printed. If we look at the result, it gives you the OR resultant. So as you can see, 01 results in 1, 10 results in 1, 01 again results in 1, 11 again results in 1, 00 results in 0, 00 results in 0, and these two again result in 1, which is equivalent to what we calculated. Next, let's move on to the AND operator. So I'm going to copy this and then use the same here. Let's just comment out this for the file. Now, if I replace the OR operator with the AND operator, which is represented by %AND, this will perform bitwise AND operation. If you remember, the output we calculated in the lesson was decimal 136 and binary 1000. So let's run a program and see if that's what's the output we get. As you can see, it printed the right output. Next, let's move on to the XOR operator. I'm again going to copy paste what we have above and then comment out this part of the code. For XOR operation, we need to use the caret sign. So A XOR B, and the result is being saved in C. Again, in the lesson, we calculated the value will be 71 of XOR operation between 202 and 141, and the binary will be 01000111. Let's see if that is correct. Again, 71 is printed as we predicted, and the value is 01000111. 0 in front of 1 has been omitted from the formatted output because it considers 0 as a non-value. Now let's move on to the next operator, which is the ANOR or the bit clear operator. Again, I am going to comment out the value here and then replace or just add %AND in front of it. Now if you remember from the lecture, we calculated the value of C to be 66 in decimal and 01000010 for binary. Let's see if that is the result we get. So we got 66 as we expected, and again the 0 in front has been omitted, but we have the correct answer. If you remember, AND NOT operator will only set the resultant bit if the bit is set in the first number but not in the second. So you can see 01 should result in 0, 10 should result in 1, 01 again should result in 0, 11 should result in 0, 00 should result in 0, 00 should result in 0, and 10 should result in 1. Which is correct. The last operator we have left is the invert operator. Let's copy the value again. So now we have the invert or the not operator. I'm going to comment these values out again. If you remember, a caret sign with just a single operand performs the not operation. We don't need to print B in this case, so I'm just going to remove it. The ID is complaining because we have declared B but not using it. So I am just going to comment this out again. Now we expected the value 53 to be printed. So let's run a program and see what we get. Correct, 53 is printed and the values of the bits here are inverted in this. Again, the zeros in front of the number has been omitted. But if you check, the result is as we expect. 0 has been converted to 1, 1 is now 0, 0 is 1, 1 is now 0, 0 is 1, 0 is 1, and the 11 in front were converted to 00, which has been omitted from the output. Again, it is important to remember when you use caret sign between two operands, that is A caret sign B, it will perform the XOR operation. But if you use the caret sign like this, caret sign A, it will perform the invert operation. Again, I would like to bring it to your attention that when you're performing bitwise operation, it is good to use unsigned int to prevent any unexpected values. Since all the bits in the unsigned int are used to represent the number and the number only. But sometimes you may also need to use it on an integer. Like I mentioned in the lecture, if you want to check if a value is odd or even, you can perform an AND operation. So I'm just going to comment this out and this out. Along with this, we are still going to use FMT. If you remember, if I do an even number AND with 1, the output should be 0. So let's see what the output is here. Go run main.go and you can see the output is 0. If I do 11, the output should be 1 for odd numbers. The output is 1. So this is another easy way of seeing if a value is odd or even. You can also use the remainder operator to check if a value is odd or even. That's it for this lesson. In this lesson, we covered the OR operator used to perform bitwise OR. Then next, we cover AND, which is performed with %AND. Then we cover the XOR operation, which is performed by a caret sign, followed by the AND NOT, which is performed with AND and a caret sign. Then lastly, we covered the invert operation performed using caret and the number. It's good if you can practice this on your own. You can try to use it with int and see what the output is, or try out different binary operations and see if you get the expected results. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. If you have any questions, please leave a comment under the video or reach out to us in our Discord server. In the next lesson, we will cover the bitwise shift operators. So see you in the next lesson. Happy coding.